it's kind of a little bit disheartening to have your race training kind of interrupted with everything that's been going on. So I think it's a great opportunity for us to take the time to do the self-care that we need along with our running program. So with that in note, today's focus is going to be on the running population. So, I mean, runners, yes, but this is also a very good little routine to think about adding into your regime. If you do a lot of sitting, if you're someone who walks a lot, I know some of you may be watching from Labrador, you know, walking the trails in the snow with the heavy snow underfoot and a little bit of unevenness in the treading with the weather getting warmer. This is great for hips, great for glutes, and just overall general lower body stability and mobility. So we're going to start. If you want to join in, the only thing that I'm going to use today as a little bit of an additive help would be, I have two yoga bricks here. I'm a huge fan of the bricks, and just because they help kind of, they just help give you a little bit of an extra bit of range of motion so that you're not straining through to the end range to get your work done. So if you don't have anything similar to this at home, it's okay. You can use the modifications, but you can also, I mean, this is, for any students out there, this is probably the size of a nice Biology 100 textbook. it's also a great size if you were to take maybe one or two books, or actually I believe one of the Harry Potter books would be close to this size. So something along that line, just something to give you that little bit of a lift from the floor so that you're closer when you reach. So I'm just going to leave those here beside my mat, and we're going to start in a very popular pose called Child's Pose. So we're going to take those knees a little bit wider, and normally with a Child's Pose, our feet are flat, but we're going to, I'm not sure if you can get a good view of my feet here, but I've got my toes tucked and the weight of my hips, I've got my sit bones tucked on top of the weight of my feet. So in this position, I'm going to let my knees walk a little bit wider, and I'm going to shift my weight, my body weight, down onto the heels. And this is already starting some of our therapy type of running yoga here, because we are giving a nice gentle stretch to that lovely plantar fascia. So with all the runners out there, if you are joining in at home, you can probably feel this in your toes and in the arches of your feet. So that is enough of a little bit of awakening there. We're just going to take our weight, put it on our hands, tuck those toes underneath now, flatten out the top of the foot, and settle ourselves down in between our heels. We're going to walk our hands forward, placing our forearms down like a railway track, and we're going to tuck the head down. And in this position here, this is basically where one of those little bricks would come in handy for anyone who's really tight in their spine. So we have our brick, and we place it high enough so that our forehead can rest on the top. And we're going to focus on just taking some deep breaths in, trying to breathe in through the nose, sending the air through the nose, down the back of the throat, past the chest, and into the belly. And in this position here, as we breathe, the belly will press against the thighs, and we'll feel that nice natural resistance against our big belly breath. And again, if you don't have a brick, that's totally fine. You can take the elbows wider, clasp the hands together, and place the head in the fists. So not really focusing on the stretch in the upper body here, focusing on feeling the weight of the hips relax, feeling our sit bones push away from each other. And perhaps for those runners that have a little bit of tension around the ankles, feeling a little bit of extra pressure on the front of the ankle joints. And you may need to shift your weight around a little bit just to feel that nice happy space where we feel the best zone of comfort. So again, just a little bit of a yin sort of pose, more so to slow the body down and get the body ready for some opening that we're going to do when we flow through a sequence here for the hips. Deep breath in. Feel the belly fill as we exhale, releasing the air from the belly, passing the chest, up the back of the throat, and out through the nose. Chin, lifting the head, tucking those elbows back in underneath us, bracing our hands, palms forward, thumbs pointing in, lifting ourselves out, tucking those toes once more, bringing the knees in so that they're under the shoulders, that's funny, under the hips, hands under the shoulders, knees under the hips, and we tuck those feet back under, tuck the toes in, feel that gentle stretch here. The back is nice and strong. We're not arching through, we've got a nice strong core. So we're lifting the chest up away from the shoulder joints. We're tucking our tail and pulling the abdominals in. Think about your Kegels. So from here, taking the left leg or the right leg, tucking those toes back, pushing the heel down. Think about start blocks here and you're running. So just opening up the line of the back of the leg, keeping the weight even from right to left in the hand, and of course not forgetting to put some weight into that left knee. So pressing the heel back, feeling the heat, feeling the stretch come up the back side of that calf, up around the back of the knee, into the thigh. Now squeeze the glute again, don't let your body drop. Lift up and out, tuck the tail. Feel everything turn on and engage. Good, don't forget to breathe. From here, we just take that leg back in, settle it underneath, find the happy medium. Take a deep breath in, let the belly drop, look forward. Just arching, deep breath. Exhale, tuck the chin, push up, arching into cat. Inhale, leading with the belly. Inhale, lifting, opening up into cow. Exhale again, tucking that chin, curling back under. Just opening up spinal mobility, going through that a few more times. Allowing some nice mobility between the facet joints and the spine. Exhale. Coming back now to flat back, taking our left leg back, driving the heel back behind us, again, evening the weight left to right and into that right knee, turning on the quad, pushing the heel away, feeling that stretch rise up through the back of the leg, into the thigh, turning on the glute, pulling the abdominals up and in, and lifting the chest out of the shoulder. Good, feeling the heat, just getting a little bit of opening through the sciatic nerve path in the back side of the leg. Very, very gentle, but really effective. Taking that knee back in now, and just take a moment, shift the knees wide, press the body back again, and sit down and feel how much easier, just with that little stretch, how much easier we can fall through and hinge at the hips, so that we can now get a little bit more opening in those hips. Deep breath in and out. Moving on, bringing the body back up, walking the hands in towards the knees. We tuck those knees in. We're gonna take the left leg forward. We're gonna come into almost like a lunge position here. So I've got a 90 degree bend in the front. I've got my leg tucked behind me. And this is where my brick is gonna come in for support. So you can see how it gives me this extra lift. I don't have to overreach, even though I have the flexibility to do so. When I overreach, I automatically twist. And what we're looking at doing is keeping a neutral torso while we open the hips. So this brick is really nice. The other hand, I'm placing my forearm on the top of my thigh, just above my knee, for brace. So you know you're in a good spot. When I bring my arm up 90 degrees, my hand should fall right into my shoulder. So that's telling me that I'm nice and neutral in my torso, and I'm just about to do leg work only. So from this position, we go back to that long outstretched leg. So we've lifted the leg off the ground. From here again, coming out of the shoulder joint, we inhale and open our chest towards that front left thigh, reaching up. As we exhale, we square the body and wrap that left arm around and tuck it into our shin. Inhale, look forward, squeeze the right glute. Exhale, twist back in. Inhale, wrap and lift. Stay for the exhale. Settle in the hips. Inhale, open and twist. Exhale, curl, lock into that shin. Inhale, grow long. Exhale, drop the knee. And now we shift our weight back, coming from hip flexor and thigh and glute, now into a half split. So again, option here to use that brick to come across the thigh, if need be, allowing a little bit of support. So we're getting a beautiful stretch on that back Achilles and plantar fascia, and we've got ourselves planted ever so gently, still keeping our weight even Stevens in the middle. Inhale, pull the toe towards your nose. Exhale, press the toe away. Inhale, pull. Exhale, press. Inhale, pull. This next one, exhale, press that toe away, come back up, hinging forward, taking the hands inside this time. And again, if you can't reach the floor easily, we've got our brick to hold us up a little higher. So from this position, we lift, drop the knee back a little further, allow the toes to fall inward, and we open the left leg out to the side. So the left knee is falling out to the side. We've got our elbows tucked in and underneath the chest to prop us up like a tripod. Feeling a beautiful stretch now on that inner left groin of that front leg. Inhale, lift the chin, squeeze the glutes. Exhale, release the head. Inhale, lift. Exhale, release. Inhale, lift. Exhale, release. Good. Bending through that back knee, tucking the toes again, hinging that front left knee back to the front. We now press up off the ground using our brick, or if our hands are on the ground, we go back into our plank. From plank, walking so that our heels drop down, and now we are into our down dog. So just here momentarily, again, no brick, no worries. From the down dog, we tuck the knees, we bring the body in, and we get ready to do the whole other side. So now in this position, you'll be able to see my leg a little bit better. I know it might have been a little tricky on that angle, but I'll show you everything now. We're gonna go through on the other side. So bringing the right leg forward, setting up our lunge, 90-90. Notice the back toes are tucked, and I have my brick here to lift and support. So in this position, I know I'm in the right spot. When I put my elbow on that front thigh, if I reach right across, I'm coming right into my shoulder. So that's where that brick really does come help give you that mobility aid. From here, opportunity to stay down with that knee or to grow long and strong through that back thigh, turning on the glute to stabilize. From this position, we inhale, open our body towards that front leg. Exhale, releasing, squaring the body down, reaching that arm in, tug underneath the shin. Inhale, squeeze the shin, lift the torso long. Stay for the exhale. Inhale, opening back, twisting into that front leg. Exhale, wrapping, squaring, tucking. Inhale, lift, grow strong. Exhale, stay. Inhale, open again. Exhale, curl, square. Inhale, squeeze and lift. Exhale, dropping the back knee, hinging the weight back, bringing our brick, if need be, in for support. Again, resting the left sit bone on the left heel, stretching the plantar fascia on the left foot, working on the hamstring on the right. Tucking the fingertips down using a tripod, keeping the spine strong and controlled. Inhale, pull the toes toward your nose. Exhale, press away. A little bit of flossing here. Inhale, pull. Exhale, push away. Inhale, pull. Exhale, push. One more inhale. Exhale, push the foot down, hinge the body forward, taking that brick, bringing it back up for support, or bringing both hands down on the inside of that front leg. From here, we grow long in the left, inch that foot back so we get that little bit of an added stretch. You can drop the knee back down, place the sole of the foot in the air, put the top of the foot down. And then we take that right leg and we just hinge it. Think about a hinge by your pinky toe. You're opening up your foot like a book. Good. Body stays square and center. And we turn those elbows in, thumbs point straight forward, put a slight bend, and we lock our body into our arms like a tripod. Inhale, lifting through the chin to tighten and stretch. Exhale, releasing the head to floss the spine. Inhale, leading with the chin, lifting up and through. Exhale, release. Inhale, lift and look. Exhale, release. Good. Inhale, lift and look. Stay for the exhale, tucking those left toes back again. Shifting our weight to the left to allow that right foot to come back. Placing our hands neutral, fingers forward, thumbs pointing towards each other. Lifting that back leg, left leg, long, strong, stepping the right leg back. Hinging into the down dog. Pedal the feet. Take some breaths. Walking it out. You may hear some creaks and cracks at this point with that little gentle hip stretch. Taking the knees back down wide. Releasing the feet. And sitting the body back down. Head, chin tucked, forehead down. Deep breath in. And exhale. Good. Walking those hands in. Bringing the body up. And that is a very nice, gentle approach to some work that will help your running greatly. If you think about the muscles that we focused on, was everything from the belly down, but it was all about functional integration of those muscles. First, thinking about getting a nice long line through the backside of our leg, which sometimes we don't really get very much often a chance to do so in daily life. So straightening and lengthening and giving the ability for everything to lengthen, followed by activation of the glutes and the core, followed by opening, stabilizing the hips and torso against internal external rotation to give us that freedom in the pelvis to move uninhibited. So thank you so much for tuning in. For those of you that have been following along and perhaps maybe even practicing a little bit there, I welcome your feedback and I hope to see you in more of these situations soon. Take care. Thank you.